Hey everyone, bringing you another video review. This time, Transformers the Movie 2007, Voyager-class Starscream. As you can see, he's an F-22 Raptor jet. Huge difference between this one and the Revenge of the Fallen version. This one has a ton of kibble on it. I thought this was a very nice looking figure until the Revenge of the Fallen version came out, which I have right here. So as you can see, there is a difference. Huge difference being that this one is all tattooed up. And this one's just regular. The Revenge of the Fallen version is a lot more movie accurate. But I would recommend getting this one, because it is a different mold. And if you have the first one already, I would recommend getting the Revenge of the Fallen version. That way you have both molds, and I think they're both really cool figures. To begin transformation. Oh, and this is a requested review. Before I begin, the Hot Rod Shot. To begin, just want to pop these panels up right here, just like that. There. And you want to come around. You want to separate this part right here, just like that. There we go. Separate just like that to bring it out. And push this piece up just like that. It activates the automorph feature. I'm going to end up having to raise the camera. One second. Here we go. It's a little better. But this does activate the automorph feature, as you can see. Rotate this up. Separate these pieces. There and there. Pull the arms out. And they just rotate down just like that. You want to come around to the back. You want to split the legs just like that. Actually, before you do, rotate these panels up right here. Get up under them, lift them up, just like that. Rotate these out, these pieces, rotate them out. Take the legs, pull them up, and rotate them down, just like that. Up, and rotate it down. Then you can go ahead and close these back up, rotate the legs out. Fold this piece down, rotate this piece up, and it pegs into the back. Right here. Pegs right in. Just like that. And you want to rotate the legs. Flip them back. Just like that. Do the same with this side. Go back. Rotate this forward. Flip his feet out. That about does it for the legs. It's a pretty big figure. Raise the camera again. There we go, that's better. Sorry about that. And then with these pieces right here, these panels, just want to kind of fold these out of the way. Yeah, they do like to pop off. They're just on ball joints. And they go right back on. Just like that. You want to fold this wing in like that. And as you do, rotate it back. Yeah, you know what? It's easier to just take these panels off. Fold it, rotate it back. Same with this side. Fold it, rotate it back. And then with these pieces, rotate them, just like that. Now, I have seen them done differently. I have seen people do them like that. I prefer that. It's all in what you prefer. Whatever you think makes the figure look better. And then these panels, just put them, pop them right back on, just like that. And just like that. There we go. And then the arms, rotate these. This area up, fold it down. Rotate this up, fold it down. And rotate his arms out, just like that. And these are his hands. These are supposed to be like his fingers right here. So just flip these out. That's what I like about the Revenge of the Fallen Starscream better. It has better hands. I do have the missiles, all of them. Comes with 6. And just like that. And when you turn this, this little piece right here, as you turn it, comes in contact with these pieces, which shoots the missile, which I'll show you. Just like that. And it is pretty powerful. I prefer to leave them out. Because if you kind of just tap them, they tend to come out. Very nice figure. I didn't do a size comparison in vehicle mode, but I apologize for that. I will do one for robot. Okay, we can compare him to Blackout from the first movie. As you can see, to the top of the head, he's a lot taller than Blackout, but this right here evens him out. And they will be releasing a figure, almost the same version as Blackout, but will be called Grindor. And that is in my new Revenge of the Fallen Toys update. Will be a Voyager class. We can compare him to first movie Ironhide, my custom one. As you can see, they're about the same. I got quite a few size comparisons for you. Figure I don't usually do a whole lot. Wouldn't hurt to do a few. Compare them to first movie Barricade. So, pretty standard size for a Voyager class. And they do have a Revenge of the Fallen Barricade. I don't think it's worth getting. It's called Interrogator Barricade, and he just comes with them two claws that attach right here. Instead of having Frenzy, claws go inside here and you can attach them to the front. I don't think it's worth it. If you have this one from the first movie, don't bother getting the second one. You can compare him to Deluxe Class Bone Crusher from the first movie. So as you can see, a lot bigger than Bone Crusher, but he is pretty short for a Deluxe Class. And my last comparison will be with Revenge of the Fallen Sideways. This is my custom Sideways. So, as you can see, top of the head, a lot taller, but these panels right here do make him a little bit taller than Starscream. Not by much, but a little. But there he is. Transformers the Movie 2007, Starscream.